Jerry trying to dig for the first time, the left hook to the body. That really is his best punch.
There, Alex. Balance, something that Gil Clancy has said that he really wanted to work on with Jerry Quinn. Oh, there's a left from George. Good left to the body.
Without the mouthpiece for the remainder of the round.
Oh, there's that jab of Foreman again getting in.
George, not just in contrast to Jerry Koonin, George is a little bit quicker than he has been in his 19 fights of his comeback. That wild amateur is Foreman right to the body.
When you look at Koonin, there's a couple.
Foreman was able to take advantage of it. But again, Jerry in a corner. And that time, Jerry got a little left hook and he wobbled Big George. First.
The final 10 seconds of the first round. There was a big right to the ribs by George.
Take a look at the mouthpiece being knocked out. That jab by George Foreman. Then the second jab behind it. And Jerry Cooney's mouthpiece came out. Action later in the round. Watch the inside left hook by Cooney. Not there. Not there, but there. And that punch moved George Foreman.
Team prior fights.
They're just not in this.
There's a good left counter by Cooney.
He came in here with a much more serious look. He's got millions and millions of dollars at stake here.
Well, they're
going to get it anyway. He's risking everything.
And another right.
George putting pressure on Cooney, backing him around the ring just by walking. Chosen to stand his ground and trade punches. He's been fighting his first. There, standing his ground, punching, and then trying to move out of the way. Obviously,
and there is the big roundhouse left. The trademark punch of George. Blow by Cooney. Went undetected by Joe Cortez.
Good inside uppercut by Foreman.
Come on. He's in big trouble. He's ready to go. And there he goes.
Two, three, four.
And he is badly hurt.
Five,
same
six,
position he was in round seven, five against Spinks. A clubbing right hand by Foreman.
Okay.
Now let's see.